Greetings. There are really so many things to mention. Greece is certainly a problem for the Europeans and Greeks, but has your lamestream media failed to mention China's problems? Chinese chaos worse than Greece. While the world worries about Greece, there's an even bigger problem closer to home, China. But to be accurate and fair, the Chinese stock market, the Shanghai Compound Index, had peaked up 150% to 5166 from 2000 only a year ago. On the other hand, it should scare you to your core and wake you from your slumber. When the dominoes begin to fall, the process will be impossible to stop. I think the USA has problems which are still being hushed by the obitches. Have you noticed a can of tuna is now only 5 ounces? And still getting more expensive. The value of the dollar has begun the process of collapse. The only thing saving the dollar is that it is still the best currency in the world. On the one hand, that might bring you some comfort if your savings and money are in US dollars. On the other hand, it should scare you to your core and wake you from your stupor. When the US economy collapses, there is no one to bail us out. But then scholars of the Bible have long known that the world's economies must collapse to make way for the one world economy. Revelation 6:6, I heard what sounded like a voice from somewhere among the four living creatures. It said, a quart of wheat will cost you a whole day's wages. 3 quarts of barley will cost you a day's wages too. But don't ruin the olive oil or the wine. And in that situation of collapse and crisis, the Antichrist will be able to impose an economic system on much of the world. Revelation 13:16, and he causes all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell save he that has the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name. That always seemed so far-fetched to me, and America seemed so financially strong when I was growing up. Now we're $17 trillion in debt, with $127 trillion in unfunded liabilities. Unfunded means there is no source for the money, except your children and grandchildren. At times, it seems too obvious that selfish human nature must result in what the Bible has predicted. Socialism appeals to selfish people who hide behind a mask of caring. It seems good to claim one is taking care of the poor, but the real undeclared motivation is still selfishness. Guilt is selfish. It is self-awareness. If you feel moved to acts of charity, you need to be charitable. I personally know too many people who voted for Obama because of what they would get. They had relatives who wanted the good life in America, but wanted it now, illegally. They have medical issues and want what they think will be free medical care. They do not care about the cost to others and the long-term failure their selfishness will cause. This is exactly what we see in the selfish Greeks today. Human nature, selfishness, regardless of the consequences. Mix that with a current culture of godlessness, or more precisely, an anti-God rebelliousness, and the stage is set for the Antichrist to rise to power. Now, does anyone have an economic system which might survive the coming collapse? It would have to be somewhat independent of the current economic house of cards. Our fragile framework, based on debt and interest and assumptions of endless growth. I think that will readily be found in the economics of Islam and the Sharia, which is not based on debt management. This only covers the current economic fragility caused by human selfishness and stupid socialism. What if there were other cards in this fragile house over which we had no control? What if the bees that pollinate all our foods began mysteriously disappearing? From 2013, declining bee populations pose a threat to global agriculture. This issue even made it into an episode of Doctor Who several years ago. Just imagine how important food is, and this issue begins to jump out at you. What if the sun is really cooling and we are entering another minimum? From this past Wednesday, Britain faces freezing winters as slumps in solar activity threatens Little Ice Age. America's most advanced climate station data shows us in a 10-year cooling trend. Global warming is, after all, caused by the sun, stupid. And twice before, during the Maunder minimum and the Dalton minimum, the sun quieted and the world experienced ice ages. Just remember, human survival is much harder during ice ages, as the plant and vegetable growing regions localize to only the equatorial regions. And I'm still not talking about the 2.5 mile wide elephant in the room. There seem to be a plethora of videos and stories about some asteroid, and about Planet X, or Nibiru. The conspiratorial scuttlebutt is that the asteroid hits in late September 2015. But if that has any legitimate possibility, I think that would be a welcome event. I mean, we'd likely be raptured just days or weeks before. Or we'd die in the flashbang and either way be with the Lord. The only thing which legitimizes the asteroid hype, in my mind, is this. Revelation 8:8, and the second angel sounded, and as it were a great mountain burning with fire was cast into the sea, and the third part of the sea became blood. That sounds pretty much like an asteroid ocean impact event to me. But I think we'll be raptured before that particular cataclysm. Have I left anything out? Well, yes, because of the length of this video already. I would summarize things this way. The end is coming, and nothing may be done to stop it. It may be a few years away, or it may only be a few months away. Luke 21:28. But when these things begin to take place, straighten up and lift up your heads, because your redemption is drawing near. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.